We are under the bright lights tonight as MLB Network welcomes you to this presentation of Major League Baseball. It's the first of a brief two-game set between the Texas Rangers and the Philadelphia Phillies. It's Interleague Baseball on MLB Network. Zach Eflin will be on the mound for the series opener. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, this guy loves pitching at home. He's had a little bit of a rough go pitching on the road so far this season, but he's pitched really well in his home environment, and I'm sure he's glad and comfortable that he's pitching at home in this one. Hopefully, he can string together another strong home start.
Here's Elvis Andrus now, and we are set for baseball here this evening. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. And he lays off ball four, and the leadoff man is on to begin the ball game. So next to the plate for Texas, Matt Duffy. He's ready for his first at bat of this early season contest. Two balls and two strikes to Duffy. And set up behind the plate is Joe McDonald, as you see the rest of our umpiring crew in this one.
Hey, Joe McDonald, he's a tough guy to figure out sometimes, D-Row. One inning, he'll be given that inside corner. The next inning, he doesn't give much of that inside corner. His zone fluctuates a lot.
You know, Dan, you could see some definite confusion on the face of some hitters today. Questioning in the strike zone. One pitch is a strike on the outer half. The next time, it's a ball. Kind of a little cat and mouse with the umpire when you should be focused on the pitcher.
Wow, he almost blew that fastball by him, but he shows some quick hands to catch up to it and drive it down the opposite line. Didn't keep it fair by much, but he did, and that's a nice two-bagger.
Into the box now, Willie Calhoun. Now the catcher wanted it down, and they got him to chase it for strike two. Set. Here's the 2-2. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
Definitely in a tough situation facing the three hitter. You can work around him and maybe walk him to load the bases, but that just sets up the cleanup guy with the bases loaded.
And he fouls this one off.
It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
The next 3-2. Ani pops it up. Segura into shallow left, but he won't get there. It falls in. The throw home. And not in time as the run scores.
Boy, that has to feel good as a hitter, D-Roy. You get that base hit to give your team the lead. You have to feel good when you get down to first base.
Yeah, it's just a nice approach. You see him turn to his boys right there and get fired up with the dugout. 100%, not trying to do too much, able to quiet the moment down, center himself, and come through in a big spot.
In now, Joey Gallo. A ball and two strikes now.
One and two.
The 1-2.
Two and two.
Well, two straight fastballs inside haven't put him away, so now it'll be interesting to see what he turns to.
Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. He pulls this one into right, and that'll get down out there. And that'll plate their second run of the game as they take a 2-0 lead.
You don't think being a starting pitcher in this league will test your resolve? He's already given up more runs in the first inning of this one than he did his entire last start. That's the kind of roller coaster ride that will make you a little crazy, but that's kind of how baseball works sometimes.
Into the box, Danny Santana. This pitch is popped up. Here for it is Segura to make the play. One gone. Up next for the Rangers, Ronald Guzman. It's been a really slow start to the season for him, as you can see by the April numbers on your screen. Calhoun over at second. Gallo is over at first with one away. And it's 1-2.
I don't blame the batter for pulling the trigger right there. Those fastballs light up your eyes, and you can occasionally do damage with them, but he wasn't able to catch up with that one.
To two balls and two strikes now. Still even at 2-2. From the belt, kicks and deals.
I got 3-2.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
And it's fouled away. Up to an even 30 pitches here in the first inning. And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at bat.
One thing to know is not all strikeouts are created equal. Right there, he goes down on strikes, but he really made that guy on the mound work for it. And when you're doing that in the first inning, it can have an effect on how deep he's going to be able to go into this start. There's a big difference between that and going down on 3 or 4 pitches.
Oh, no, he can't hold on to it. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. So 2 runs on 3 hits, no errors, and a couple of men left. On now to the bottom of inning number 1. Texas is out in front, 2-0. Kyle Gibson, the right-hander out of Indiana, will be doing the pitching in this one. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, Matt, coming on Kyle Gibson to pitch. 4 pitch mix. Not an overpowering guy, more of a pitch to contact kind of guy. Fastball 89 to 93, curveball, changeup, and slider. He's a guy you'll know if he's on early. He's going to induce a lot of ground balls. If he's getting pop-ups and fly balls, that's dangerous. He's not a power-type pitcher.
So coming to the plate, Gene Segura. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And a slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2. The pitch. Hit on the ground out to short. Andrus has it. Throw on to first, and one shortstop grounds out to the other, one away. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that'll bring up the former National League MVP, Andrew McCutchen. Now the 1-1 pitch is looked at for ball number 2. And fellas, you take a look at this Rangers team entering play here tonight. They've been in a nice little groove, winning 3 of their last 4 games.
Yeah, Matty, I've been really impressed with this team, especially on the recent road trip, the start to it. They're 3-1 after 4 games, playing really fundamentally sound baseball. From offense to defense, pitching, it's all coming together for this group.
And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
To be honest with you, I'm a little bit more afraid of the guy on deck than the guy that's up right now. If I'm on the mound, I want this guy up right now. He's the guy that's got to beat me.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Another full count pitch home. And he missed with that one. It's ball 4. A 1-out walk here in the home first.
And you can tell by his body language that he's beyond frustrated by that call. He's got to be wondering what he's got to do, but the last thing he needs to do is to let it get under his skin. That will only make things worse.
So a runner at first with one man gone, and that'll bring up Bryce Harper. And he held up in time, but it's strike three called, and there are two down.
You know, I'm not quite sure how that strikeout will be scored, looking or swinging. He tried to check his swing, but I'm pretty sure the home plate umpire was ringing him up regardless.
Throw over to the bag, and the runner back safely. A runner on first with two away. And another throw over, keeping particularly close tabs on him. At the plate, Rhys Hoskins.
Whoa, that's him.
Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1.
Hasn't seen a heater yet in this at bat. One might be coming right here.
He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. A swing and a miss on a ball way outside the strike zone, and the inning is over. Phillies strand one. They trail it here 2-0. Into the box now, Jose Trevino. He was 1-for-4 in Sunday's affair. Line to the right side. Bob, that finds the first baseman's glove, and that's a tough first out. Striding in, Kyle Gibson. Outside, 2-1. These Phillies, as they enter play here tonight, fellas, they come in off a loss last time out, but they've been playing well, winners of 5 straight prior to that game.
Yeah, Matty, I don't think yesterday's loss should be a focus on this team whatsoever. I think they showered that one off. They had a big winning streak coming into their last game. Dropped that one, but let's see if they start another winning streak today.
Hoskins is over now, and he's got it for route number 2. Stepping into the box, Elvis Andrews. He scored after reaching on a walk in his first at-bat. Here it comes now to Andrews. Ground ball sent back up the middle, and that will be a base hit for Andrews.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dan. Sent it back right where it came from.
So now to the plate, Matt Duffy. And here's a ball in the air now, carrying a bit out toward right center. Harper is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Rangers leave one, but they're on top 2-0. Here's Didi Gregorius. Now the 2-1. goes the other way as this is hit high and deep out to straightaway left.
Gone!
A solo shot here to left. Home run number 5 on the year. And the Phillies have cut the lead in half. It's now a 2-1 game.
Listen, there's an old adage in baseball that solo home runs won't kill you. This is one of the top hitters in that lineup. So a home run, a solo home run right here, it's not the end of the world.
At the plate now, JT Realmuto. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike 2. Base is empty here with nobody out. Now a swing and a ball popped in the air back behind short. And Andrus will take this one in with 2 hands for the first down. So one away here with the bases empty. And digging in at the plate, the Texas native Nick Williams. Ball and 2 strikes.
Wow, I can't believe the hitter took that one. The pitcher absolutely got away with a hanger.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Santana is under this one, and he's got it for out number 2. Digging in now for Philadelphia, Scott Kingery. He's ready for his first at-bat of this early season contest. Now the 3-2 pitch. Line to the right side. But a good play by the first baseman to spear this one, and that'll retire the side. Some of our nation's young minds and future leaders here in attendance. Yikes. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. Striding in once again, Willie Calhoun. Looking to follow up the RBI single from his first at bat. And he popped him up. And that'll get down for a base hit. With that, the Rangers get their leadoff hitter on base after the inning opening base hit. So he's aboard again with his second hit of the game here in the top of the third. And as we check out the Rangers leaders in that category, you can see his total currently second best on the ball club. Stepping in now, Joey Gallo. Maybe too much break on the slider. 2-1. Nobody out, runner on first. Swing and a screamer, but this one's not going to stay fair. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at bat going. Here's another 2-2. And he takes ball 3, so it's a full count now. Here comes the payoff pitch. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. 8th pitch of the at-bat coming up. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. Payoff pitch one more time. Line toward the gap in left center. That's in another base hit. He's 2-for-2.
I know this guy isn't known for his hitting prowess, but that's a nice job right there. Getting a single on a 3-2 pitch in the middle of the zone. Grab your glove and flash some leather.
In now, Danny Santana. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. A 2-1 score here as we play inning number 3. popped him up. And he will make the play, and an important one it was, as those runners will have to hold now with one away. Digging in for his second at bat, Ronald Guzman. He got called out on strikes his last time through.
Yeah, always frustrating to go down looking. Everybody does it, though. You'll have a few ABs where you get completely fooled. Look for him to be on the attack early in this at bat.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Now the 2-1 pitch. He pulls this one into right. Harper is there. Two down. And he'll make it up safely to third, so they're at the corners now with two men out. So two are gone here in the Rangers third, and that'll bring up the second baseman, Rougned Odor. Already 24 pitches to this point in the inning. Fouled off. He's set. The payoff pitch. Fouled away. Popped up. Hoskins is there for it. And the inning is over. Rangers leave a pair as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. So next to the plate for the Phils, Zach Eflin. He'll get to take his first cuts here. And this is low, ball two, 2-1. Swing and a liner, but foul. Sent on the ground out to second. And there's one down now. And with that, let's take a moment to show you what's happening in the American League's Western Division. So it's back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in the middle infielder, Gene Segura. One out, nobody on. Swing and a liner. Foul. Swing and a little blooper to center. And that's in there. Base hit. Digging in, Andrew McCutchen. He drew a base on balls his first time up. The 1-1 pitch. Left side. Odor. On to Guzman, they get them both, and that retires the sign. Around the horn they go. 5-4-3 to end the threat. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this. And we're back from Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia. Let's check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, I talked with the Rangers manager during the inning break about the team's offensive production to this point. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. It's still pretty early in the game, but they've seen a lot of pitches already, and he thinks the two runs they've pushed across so far is just the beginning, given the quality of the at-bats they're putting together.
Thank you, Heidi. Digging in, Jose Trevino, as we begin the top of the fourth. skied into very shallow right. Harper has a read on it. One down. Now to the plate, the pitcher, Kyle Gibson, 0 for 1 after a pop out in foul territory his first time through.
Yeah, this one's going to upset him for a little bit. You make the pitcher work the way he did right there, and that's the end result. That one sticks with you for a while.
And he fouls this one off. Here's the 1-2 delivery.
That's the ball.
I don't know if that was discipline or whether he's just not swinging the bat at all, but hey, at least he's making the pitcher throw a few more pitches.
And a half-hearted attempt that time, but they'll say he broke the plane, and that's out number two.
For me, check swings are right there next to bang-bang plays at first as the most difficult calls for an ump to make. Taking a look at show motion, the batter doesn't appear to hold up enough, so I think the call was right.
Swung on and hit in the air out toward left. Coming on is McCutchen. He's got it. A great running play, and that'll retire the side. Rangers set down in order. They lead it 2-1. So striding in, Bryce Harper. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
Now the 1-1 pitch. 1-2 now. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. He pops him up toward the left side of the infield. And he'll put this one away for the first out of the inning. And now it'll be the cleanup spot for the Phillies, Rhys Hoskins. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. On the ground to the left side, there is Andrus. And the throw gets him at first on as fine a play in the hole as you're ever likely to see. Two away now. Those jump throws are always some of the most exciting plays you'll see. So here it is again with Showtrack. Shows off some great range and is still somehow able to get a lot behind the throw as his momentum was taking him the other way. Not everybody can make that play. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up Didi Gregorius. Now the 1-1 pitch. Pulled toward right center field. Center fielder on the run. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. They still trail it here, 2-1. All set for the start of the inning. Digging in to try it again, Matt Duffy. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Keeping it down here as it's to 1-2. Now some movement out in the Phillies bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
Boy, there's the perfect pitch right there, the straight changeup. He hadn't used it yet in this at bat, and what does he do? He uses it, pulls the string, and gets the big strikeout.
Standing in now, Willie Calhoun. Full count now, 3-2.
Boy, this guy's got it going on right now. He's executing everything. He should feel pretty good. He's retired 7 in a row.
Pulled high in the air out to right field. Harper has a read on it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up Joey Gallo. Now the pitch.
Ball, that's inside.
Popped him up. Kingery is calling for it. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Rangers. They still lead it 2-1. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, I talked with Philadelphia's manager during the break about the Phillies' offensive production to this point. And he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said they've been chasing at pitches out of the zone all game, which obviously doesn't usually lead to good results. Until they start being more selective with their swings, he said they will continue to struggle.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Stepping in, JT Realmuto, the winner of last year's Silver Slugger Award for NL catchers. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Weakly hit towards first. Scooped up, and he'll step on first for the out. Three unassisted. Up next will be Nick Williams. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Throw in time at first for out number two. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up the former first rounder Scott Kingery. This is line to left. That's his first base hit, making one for two now. So at the very least, that two out base hit will prevent the pitcher spot from leading off the next inning.
And they keep the inning alive with a base hit, but you can see that's only the third hit he's given up the entire game, so he's still in total control out there.
Neil Walker will look for some two out magic here as he'll pinch hit with two gone and a runner at first. Fifth inning, 2-1 our score. Line drive, base hit into the left center field gap. Kingery is on his way home. And he's safe at the plate. It's a 2-2 game. Well, that was a fun play to watch unfold. And as ShowTrack tells us, the runner's speed really made all the difference, to no one's surprise. He was on his horse from the time the bat hit the ball. So a great job of hustling all the way home and beating the throw. Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in Gene Segura. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. Guzman is there to make the catch, and the side is retired. One for the Phillies here on the RBI double. Five innings complete, and we're deadlocked now at two apiece. Robert Stock takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound. New inning set to get underway. Into the box, Danny Santana. Two pop outs for him so far, so he'll look to stay through one here. Pulled toward right center field. Williams is to his left as he puts it away in the alley for the first out of the inning. So striding forward now, Ronald Guzman. Third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0 for 2 at this point. two runs, six hits, and no errors in the contest for the Rangers so far. And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. And he will run this one down, moving to his left, and that's the second out of the inning. Stepping up to the plate, Rougned Odor. He got under one and popped out his last time up.
Yeah, I don't mind him trying to drive the ball in the air, but he can't collapse the backside, and that's exactly what he did in his last at bat. Look for him to stay a little taller and keep that upper half a little bit more over him.
Ball taken there, 2-1 now. And the pitch. High and deep down the left field line. And that will end up a foul ball. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Two runs, six hits, and no errors in the contest for the Rangers so far. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. And indeed it will. He throws him out at first, and the side is retired. So they go quietly here in this half inning. 2, 3, and 4 due up in the home half of the sixth, and we are tied 2-2. Here's Andrew McCutchen now. He was a double play victim last time around.
Yeah, rolling into a two ball will eat at you for the rest of the game at least, so you know he wants to make up for it right here.
And a slider runs in on him as he has to lean out of the way. Swing and a miss, strike two.
A good fastball that backed him off the plate, and then some slow stuff down and away. That's one of the classic ways to mess up a hitter's timing. Up and in, down and away, textbook.
And that is through into right field for a single.
Pitcher executed his pitch. Good sinker down and in. Got the hitter to beat it into the ground. Sometimes there's nothing you can do about it as a pitcher.
To the plate now, Bryce Harper. No contact there, and it's 1-2.
Good thing he didn't make contact with that pitch. Only thing he could do is probably hit that on the ground. It could be a double play ball.
The 1-2. Well hit the other way, and it's into the gap. Now this will rattle up against the wall. In to score is the runner from first. It's a 3-2 ball game.
And you know, there's just so few places in the strike zone where you can keep this guy from hitting the ball hard. That really is not that bad of a pitch. Just a little bit down and away, but he's all over it, and he cashes in a run on the double.
Rangers skipper is up off his seat in the dugout now to make the walk to the mound. And a change will be forthcoming. That'll be it for Kyle Gibson. He'll wind up lasting just 5 innings here. Didn't pitch all that poorly, yet he's gone nonetheless. Jesse Chavez will come out and take the ball here as he'll be making his 15th appearance of the year. Into the box, Rhys Hoskins lays off the 1-2 changeup, and he's worked it back to 2-2.
Boy, that was an awfully close pitch right there. I know if I'm on the mound, I want that pitch called a strike. That's one of those that could go either way.
Catch made in straightaway center as the runner tags from second. And he'll make it up to third safely here with one away. Didi Gregorius will stand in here hoping to duplicate what he did back in the second inning as we flash you back to take another look at a solo home run that helped get this offense rolling.
1-1. Didi swings and belts a ball to right field. This is carrying well, but it bangs off the out-of-town scoreboard. And they'll extend their lead even further as the run from third is in to score. Into the box now, JT Realmuto hit hard up the middle, and Andrus will not be able to get there. It's a base hit.
There's a lot of moving parts in some guys' swings. It usually takes them a month or so to get it ironed out.
So now to the plate, Nick Williams. Right side, hit hard. And that's through into right field for a base hit. And they'll hold that runner at third as everybody moves up a base, and they're loaded with one away. In now, Scott Kingery. And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. From the belt, kicks and deals. In the air, down the line in left. And that will end up a foul ball. The 2-2 one more time. Hit back up the middle. Andrus to his left. He's there. Relay to first in time. And just like that, this side is retired. So it's two runs on five hits. No errors. And two left. We're through six full. The Phillies lead it 4-2. And Joe Girardi's going to get up off the dugout bench and confer at home plate. So we'll likely see a double switch here. Victor Arano will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Adam Haseley is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. Seventh inning ready to roll. In now, Jose Trevino. He's lined out and flied out in two plate appearances. The 1-2. Pops this one up. Segura moving to his left. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number seven. Shin-Soo Chu will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. Seventh inning here at the ballpark. 4-2 our score. A ball and two strikes now.
That pitch looked like it could have been a little high, but he's been calling that pitch all night. Kind of rough for a pinch hitter, but I'm sure his teammates let him know that's where the zone has been.
The 1-2. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Hit softly down the line at first. And there are two away now. So the Rangers batting order turns over and set to go. Elvis Andrus, a hit and two at bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Bases are empty here with two men out. Line towards center field. And that's in there, so perhaps some life here with two men out. So the top of the seventh isn't over yet after the two-out base hit.
Wow, I'm shocked he even pulled the trigger on that pitch. He might have been fooled right there, but he was able to keep his hands back and scramble a good pitch for a base hit.
Digging in now, Matt Duffy. And Dan, what's the plan of attack here for the guy on the mound?
Well, I think they have to go right after him. He's pretty unlikely to take you deep, but if you allow him to get on base, the chances of him scoring and tying this game become a lot greater.
Now the payoff pitch home. Sent on the ground out to second. A diving effort here as he gets a glove on it. And not really much of a chance to recover there as he'll reach first on what undoubtedly will be scored as an infield single. So they'll make a matchup move here and bring on a southpaw to face the left-handed hitter due up. And here's the former prize Dodger prospect Willie Calhoun. And with men on base and two away, it feels like this at-bat could go a long way toward deciding this thing.
No doubt, Matt. A base hit here changes this game quite a bit. But if they can't score here, it looks pretty bleak for them heading into the last couple of innings.
One and two now as that one's fouled off. From the belt, the pitch.
That's ball two.
It looked like he tried to get him to chase on that pitch there, one and two. A good idea, but I think now he has to challenge him a little bit. He doesn't want to get into a worse situation with the cleanup guy up next.
Here's the pitch on two and two. And strike three called as he says, you got to be kidding me, with the side retired. Rangers leave a pair. They trail it here 4-2. Cody Allen gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh. Into the box now, number 40. He's newly entered into the ballgame, so this will be his first trip to the plate here in inning number 7. Weak grounder back to the mound. A barehand play by Andrus. It's there. He got him. And that's a huge play to keep the leadoff man off base. Gene Segura standing in. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. A swing and a ground ball to third. Reined in. And that's the second out. So the next hitter to dig in will be Andrew McCutchen. He scored after reaching on a single in his last time up. 3-2 pitch. Oh, and he lets him off the hook there as this isn't even close for ball four. So it's a runner at first with two men out, and that'll bring in a dangerous hitter indeed in the form of Bryce Harper. All even now, 2-2. Two out with the man at first. And he lays off, so it's full now, 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
And he misses again, ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls.
He did not want to let the hitter off the hook with two outs, and now he's got a runner in scoring position to deal with.
Big spot here. First and second, two men gone, and that'll bring in a perennial MVP candidate for years to come, Rhys Hoskins. 1-1 pitch is a knuckle curve. He's in the hole now, 1-2. Still hanging with him, another good swing to keep it going. Skied into straightaway right. and the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. A couple of walks, but no damage. Back with more here on a Tuesday night after this. Here's Joey Gallo now. He's 2-for-3 thus far. Nope. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. Morgan has seen his role change with those one batter lefty specialists going the way of the dodo as a part of MLB's pace of play initiatives. Here's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone.
Hey, leading off an inning in this situation, three balls on you. You have to know that a solo shot's not tying this game up. You have to find a way to get on base any way possible.
Popped him up. Gregorius has room in foul territory. One out. Stepping up now, Danny Santana. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Getting late, 4-2 our score as we play the eighth inning. Come on, hit in the air to straightaway center. Haseley is there, two gone. David Robertson enters the ball game out of the pen, looking for the final out here in the top of inning number 8. Now at the plate, Ronald Guzman. He flew out in his last at bat. A 2-1 count to the Rangers first baseman.
You know, something to keep in mind, they're really burning through that bullpen, and this is only the first game of the series. Definitely could have an impact on the rest of the series and maybe even the whole week ahead.
The 2-1 is a sinker that dips below the zone for a ball.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. And he pushed it just a bit too much. It'll wind up a foul ball. Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Seared down the first baseline, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. And it's fouled away. Making him work out there. The ninth pitch of the at bat coming up. Fouled off. Full count, here it comes. Fouled away. Again, another foul ball. This is hit the other way out toward left field. McCutcheon is under it. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Rangers set down in order, still down by a count of 4-2. Brett Martin is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Ball
bottom of inning number 8 set to go. So now to the plate, Didi Gregorius. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. The 1-1. Here is a ground ball now for the shortstop to the right of second. On to first with it is Andrus, and it's in time, one away. Digging in and looking for more, JT Realmuto. He singled his last time up. And he fouls this one off. Here's another 1-2. Grounded up the first baseline. He's got it, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Davey Grillon will get the call to pinch hit here, as we'll see what he can do with two out and the bases empty. Two out, nobody on. Back up the middle and in for a base hit. Plate now, Scott Kingery. Breaking pitch, and this bounces in front of the catcher. The 2-1 is taken, ball 3. Hit out of play, and it's a full count now.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Now a fastball is lifted into the air to shallow center. And 8 innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one man left aboard. 9th inning coming up. Philadelphia is on top, 4-2. Sir Anthony Dominguez comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the 9th. Here's Rougned Odor now.
Looking for base runners here as they're down 2 playing on the road. Not an easy thing to do, trying to score runs or bunch hits together off of a closer.
That's going to even up the count at 2-2. Full count for Odor, 3 balls and 2 strikes.
And in a 2-run game right here, you really don't want to walk the leadoff guy to start an inning. You've got to keep that tying run in the on-deck circle as long as you can.
Now the payoff pitch home. And this pitch misses here. It's ball 4, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the 9th. Now at the plate, Jose Trevino. He's hitless in 3 at-bats to this point. A runner at first with no outs here. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. Has a look, now the pitch. Hit the other way out toward right field. Harper has a read on it, 1 away. Hunter Cole will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line.
Yeah.
This is foul right side. Runner at first here, one man out. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. So Elvis Andrus the next to bat, and he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. The 1-1 is laid off for ball two.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch, but if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
A runner on first with two away. Down the third baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Now this crowd of just over 21,000 are on their feet. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2.
Great take right there, but the last thing you want to do is be called out on strikes to end the game.
Texas down to their final strike in this one. Hit Wheatley back to the mound. Throw on to first, and the ball game is over.
Well, in a quick series like this, you take the first one, you're guaranteed at least a split. They'll take that every single time.
4-2, the final score tonight. The Phils rode an important sixth inning to victory in this one. Robert Stock gets the win in relief, his second of the year. Sir Anthony Dominguez closes the door for the save, his sixth. So that's a wrap for us here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney on the field, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB Network. Have a good night, everybody.